Devon Alexander against Timothy Bradley is like Hearns against Sugar Ray Leonard. I caught up with Devon to hear his story exclusively, was never told before. How he grew up in the rough streets of St. Louis, and how his current trainer and manager, who was a police officer back then, opened up a gym in the basement of a police building. Devon came there, and the rest is history. Check it out.
So Kevin, how did it happen that he walked into your gym? Tell me the story about being in the basement of the police station and all that.
Oh, actually, I built a gym in the basement of a vacant police building. I was working in the elementary school that he was going to school. You know, he was a student at the school where I was, that was in the district where I patrolled, and so that was the school that they assigned me to. So he was a student in that school. So.
And was one of those Beverly Hills artsy school where kids jaywalk, or was it like a school where you had to watch your back?
It was a school where you better watch your back.
Why are you laughing? What did they do? Did you terrorize them?
Yeah.
Like what?
You can't play around there, not in that neighborhood. That was a school that you had to hold your own.
So that's why you became such a good boxer? Because from age two you've been...
Yeah, I wasn't a street fighter or any gang member or nothing like that, but you did have to hold your own where I came from.
So you're in the school, you're patrolling, you're working with the kids. Obviously, you have a big heart because you see them and you want to help them.
Once I started the gym, I went out and went around to the different schools in the area recruiting kids, and Devon was one of those kids.
And you had 30 kids there.
I had over 50 kids come through my gym.
Over 50, but the statistics that I saw, 8 of them passed away. A few of them ended up in prison. Is that true?
Or? Yeah, we've had at least 8 killed and at least 10, 11 gone to prison.
Killed, like just street violence?
Yeah, just you know, gang violence, drug related, you know.
So how did you stay out of it? Like, how did you know not to like get caught up?
Well, I was just a happy-go-lucky guy. I was always smiling all the time and always wanted to go to the gym every day after school. I just loved what I did and wasn't interested in the gangs and the normal activity that I saw every day. So I just wanted to go to the gym, go to school, and just stay on the right path and do the right thing.
What's tougher, to be a police officer or to be a boxer?
I don't know. It depends, man. Being in St. Louis and being on the streets as a cop, or being in New York, L.A., Chicago, that's rough. But, being a fighter, a world-class fighter, is the toughest thing in the world, the toughest sport in the world to become a world champion. So, being a fighter, you know.
Now, don't take this the wrong way. Yeah. I know you're only 23.
Yeah.
But you look double your age. You get that a lot when people, like, you don't get, there's not a situation that you would not get carded.
Nah. Do I look double my age?
How old does he look?
Huh?
He don't look double. He looks 23.
Yeah. Okay. I don't get that a lot. I look like I'm younger. I look younger.
It's the mustache. Right. I don't know. Right. But being from St. Louis, from the rough streets, what have you learned from that, like in life? Anything?
You know, just stay focused. Stay on the right path. Don't get distracted with the negative attention and negative stuff around you. Just stay focused and try to do the right thing. That's all you can do around in that environment.
At what point did you realize, wait, I'm going to become a legend in this sport? I'm going to be really big in this sport. How did that happen?
Well, when I first started, it was just something to do at first. And I just loved doing it. And then I got to win the tournaments and continue to win big tournaments. And I just realized, like I was 15, 16, going to the Junior Olympics. And I went to Olympic trials, and I really figured that I can make a career out of this and become world champion.
Kevin, what makes him so good?
His work ethic.
Everybody works hard. Even a guy that's 1-18 works hard.
Everybody don't work hard. You know, you got some people that's got natural ability and natural talent, so they don't have a good work ethic. So, you know, everybody don't work hard. So, but, you know, his work ethic is second to none.
So there you have it, a Fat House exclusive, the Devon Alexander story before any other network. And Devon is getting in the ring in January to fight Timothy Bradley. You won't want to miss it. It's going to be fireworks. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.